you. Thank you very much, Dr. Muhammad. يعني صباح الخير everybody. يعني أنا زي ما محمد كان قال أنا هاني الجبالي. أنا CEO of AvidBeam Technologies. I'm going to talk to you today about bigger data, about يعني the mix of big data and computer vision. And I'll tell you a little bit about what AvidBeam is doing. And I'll also يعني make a glimpse about what you should be doing, what you should be looking for to prepare yourself for this type of industry and other types of industry if you're interested, both from يعني, a technical perspective and other skills that you should يعني, acquire and practice along your journey. I'm sure you're very excited about this journey. يعني, you're in good hands. يعني, I've known Muhammad for a long, long time, and he's a great mentor and a great professor. Where I'm sure يعني, you will learn a lot, and you'll have يعني, a fantastic experience at the university. But without, يعني, let me just quickly start and tell you a little bit about what we want to discuss today. So when I talk of when I say big data, what I mean is the data that are collected from surveillance cameras. Surveillance cameras are everywhere today. Cameras you see installed everywhere. If you take an example such as London, for example, they have probably installed more than almost like 500,000 cameras everywhere, probably more now. And these devices are producing a lot of data. And this data can go to waste, can be a dead investment if they are not analyzed and synthesized. So if you're just, just collecting the surveillance data as is. And by the way, I mean, people think about this, oh, this is Big Brother, this is espionage and stuff like that. No, it can actually be extremely useful for operations and for business intelligence and for gathering intelligent insights. This is just one aspect of computer vision that I'll be talking about. There are so many other aspects also that you can explore and I can also like tell you about. So if you look at the amount of data that are being produced by these surveillance cameras, you'll find that it will be producing 11 million hours of video per day. 1 hour video is about 60 gigabytes. So you can imagine if you just trying to look at the amount of data that's being produced per camera every day, this is going to be like about 720 gigabytes. And yani, the total number of cameras is huge, but per day is almost like as big as 345 petabytes. And if you look at this data and if you do nothing with this data, this is going to be going to waste. But what you would like to do is to see how I can make good use of this data, how I can synthesize in such a way that it can be it can improve my productivity, it can improve my efficiency. It can improve my sense of safety and security and so on. So yani, just to give you kada a glimpse of what the areas of focus of AvidBeam, what we do is we take the data from these surveillance cameras and we try to analyze them and extract intelligent insights that could be useful for our customers. And our customers range from people who are looking at, who are concerned about security, or people who are concerned about safety, or people who are concerned about health regulations like COVID, for example, or it could be for retailers who are interested to understand customer behavior. So they want to count the people that are coming into the store and they want to know where people accumulate, like which shelves are occupied by people and which shelves are not occupied or are not occupied by customers or not visited by customers. And people also are interested in search. They want to search for anomalies or they want to search for specific events or incidents. And also some other customers would be interested in vehicles, in tracking the vehicles and just for regular operation to, instead of using the bookkeeping using manual methods, الشخص اللي هو بيقف يريكورد مثلا license plates او كده, تقدر الحاجات دي كلها تبقى converted to be digital. So it's more, حتى even the store experience with video analytics is more like the digital transformation of these stores from to gain the online experience. In the online experience, which customer visited your site, how long they stayed, did they do a transaction or not, what their interest, which web pages they visited, and so on. You can have the same type of experience using just visual cameras inside the store, and it can give you, can bring you the online experience in a similar way. And by the way, this can be done with complete protection of the person's identity and no breach of identity or breach of security for the person. So it can be done in a completely safe way. So what are the big challenges with video analytics? The volume is big, it's intense. The amount of video that you need to process is huge. It's very time consuming because, if you're like talking about like large amount of gigabytes and petabytes, then take a long time to process, and you need like powerful machines to do these processing, and it's unstructured data. So you need to have a proper way of dealing with these unstructured video data. There are plenty of, like, when you learn, of course, programming, you learn how to do structured programming, but also in the AI domain, you have to learn about tools, and tools would be used for the learning of these devices. So you want to, so you might heard about the term training, and training means that you are preparing the machine to understand certain behavior or certain patterns or certain objects, and be able to do four things. Basically, you want to be able to detect the object, you want to be able to track the object, you want to be able to recognize the object or classify the object, and you want to be able to do analytics on the vast amount of data that you get from these analytics, so that you can detect or conclude, make some good conclusions about this data, so that it can be useful for your productivity, can be useful for your efficiency, etc. So some of the tools that are available, I'm sure some of you might heard about some of these tools, or if you haven't heard about them, I'm sure you'll encounter them in your journey. OpenCV is a well-known tool for computer vision, and it has a lot. It's open source and has a lot of open source tools that you can learn from and build computer vision models. TensorFlow is one of the tools that are heavily used for training, and it's very common in the industry to be using TensorFlow. OpenCL is a more optimized version of OpenCV, and it touches upon the GPUs and optimization libraries. Cafe also is another way of creating models for deep learning. And then what you have to do is that you build your neural network. After you build the model that you will use as the neural network model that you use for detection and for classification of objects, then you take this model and convert it into OpenCV, and then you can use it in your programs to to detect and classify objects. So just a brief overview of what AvidBeam is about. So we started back in 2015, like late 2014. We put our headquarters in the Netherlands, and all our development is in Egypt. Our focus is primarily on deep learning, big data. Of course, like we have people looking at general programming like SDKs and APIs. We have back-end people and we have front-end people because you need to develop a user interface for the customer. And everything that we do is web-based. So it's like you can access our tools from anywhere, from any computing device using an URL. So pretty much you have these four or five fields that you can, and of course the user experience is also a big part of this, especially when it comes to retail and the customers that care about like the visualization of this data. So what we do is we build a platform to process video. So we realize that we cannot chase all the computer vision in the world. So we need to have a way by which we can process video data. So we build a platform for this type of scheduling, resource management, et cetera, and processing of video. And this platform can accept computer vision plugins from that AvidBeam developed or from open source or from third parties. And it accepts also video streams in general or images or whatever in the form of a stream. And it can process the incoming streams and extract the metadata, call the metadata, and furnish this metadata to our customers. When it comes to the video surveillance ecosystem in general, like when you install video surveillance, you install cameras, and of course, like you have to install a network, and you have to install like hardware resources in order to process the cameras. But there's a very important element which is called the video management server, and this video management server is the video wall, or like the when you see the surveillance system, you'll find like many like monitors with the scenes coming from the camera, and this is what we call here like a VMS, a video management system. And there are two big companies that are dominant in this field worldwide. One is called Milestone, and the other is called Genetec. Genetec is Canadian, and Milestone is Scandinavian, from Sweden, I believe. So it's very important, like when we build these video analytics solutions, it has to be integrated with these VMSs, because you don't want to duplicate the stream so that you double the bandwidth. Like for example, if you're taking the stream from the camera, you want to take it from one source, which is the VMS, as opposed to like having to double the streams and then that way like you waste a lot of bandwidth. One coming to the VMS and other coming to your video analytics platform. That's one reason. The other reason is that you can provide your customer with just one interface where they can see everything. And that's why like integration with these VMS vendors is very important. It's also important, what we did is we created APIs, application interfaces, which is basically interfaces to our software modules so that other people can integrate with it and can use it to do other actions that are outside of video analytics. For example, based on video analytics, you can take some actions, like for example, you can open a door or you can open a gate and things like that. And that way, like the only way that that you can do it is by getting people to integrate with you. So that's something that we do. Our customers are primarily the smart cities, the banks, the enterprises, the retailers, the government, of course, technology parks, etc. We won multiple awards. One of them was at CES in Las Vegas, 2018. We got the Best AI Startup Innovation Award on the floor, among others as well. So I would like to tell you a little bit about the features and use cases that what we can do with these video analytics. So we have some focus on security and safety and business intelligence. So for security and safety, we have applications for example, facial recognition can do intrusion, making sure that people should not pass from areas that they're not supposed to do. We can do crowd detection in case of like accidents or bad incidents. We can do an early warning system for things like, for example, loitering, people who are like hanging out in areas that are not supposed to hang out in, like ATM, for example. So you can create alerts if like a thief, for example, is trying to wait for somebody who's like getting money from the ATM and they want to mug them or something like that. We have fast search for forensics and investigation. And we have also solutions for COVID-19 to detect masks and to detect occupancy, make occupancy control, count people and things like we do also social distancing and so on. On the business intelligence side, we can do things like crowd flow. We can do, we can count people. We can also detect the age and gender of people coming into the store so that we can understand the demographics. We have heat maps. Heat maps will tell you like the amount of people who accumulated around a certain table or a certain shelf. And then you can create nice graphs about what's going on and can furnish this to the customer. The target market tightener primarily airports, smart communities, parking garages, any gated communities that has anything that has a gate and they want to manage the vehicles coming in and out, retailers, malls, banks, toll roads, traffic management. We can also do lots of use cases for traffic. We can detect cars changing lanes. We can detect traffic violations, even from running red lights and things like that. We have also some industrial applications, which is primarily around we can detect the compliance of people wearing the right vests, wearing the right helmets or the head cover or the health, etc. So we can make sure that people are compliant with the industrial code inside factories. So anything that has to do with vision, it is possible that we can do with computer vision applications. The big issue with this would be primarily scaling, how to scale to a large number. So instead of like supporting only 5 or 10 cameras, you want to be able to support 5,000 or 10,000 cameras, because these are the type of the projects that people are interested in these days. So just to give you a glimpse of how this thing or how the solution is being put together without getting into too much detail, we have here a whole bunch of computer vision applications that were developed by AvidBeam. And then we have the platform, which we call Atun. And this platform will accept from one side video streams coming from surveillance cameras, or they could come from video files. And then you have plugins, several plugins, computer vision plugins. And then you extract the information and put it inside the database. And you have like a metadata database. And this metadata database can be displayed to the customer in the form of nice graphs or visuals of some sort. So that's pretty much the main implementation or the main architecture that we have inside AvidBeam. So these are some of the products that we sell to our customers. We have mainly five products or five category of products. So face recognition, and it has many features underneath it, including allow, deny list, whitelist, blacklist, face recognition. You can do face search. You can do also reverse image search if you're searching inside the database about a person. So there are so many. So people think that, oh, this could be like invasion of privacy, but there are so many applications that are very useful. We use this primarily for attendance. So a lot of people today, like instead of like the fingerprint attendance system, they want to use something that is contactless, so that in the COVID, you don't want to touch any surfaces. We don't want people to be touching the same surfaces to reduce the possibility of carrying العدوى والحاجات دي. What we do here is we implement a fast face recognition solution so that they can quickly pass and can be validated by their faces and then pass with their badge, so it's two-factor authentication. With the reverse image search, there is also a nice national project that we participated in, which is كان عن الأطفال التائهين أو in general الأشخاص التائهين. يعني في برضو يعني أشخاص كبار بيعانوا من بعض الأمراض ما بيبقوش عارفين بيكونوا تاهوا بيكونوا بنقدر نحن نرجعهم لأهليهم بأن احنا بنتشيك على الداتا بيس بتاع مراكز الأيتام المختلفة وبنقدر نحن نعرف الناس دي ممكن تكون موجودة في أي حتة وبالتالي بيقدروا يعني يسترجعوا لأهليهم بالشكل ده. AvidGuard is one of the anomaly detection products that we have. And anomaly detection here, يعني it ranges from intrusion to crowd detection to somebody يعني leaving a bag behind, abandoned objects زي في المطارات مثلا لو حد ساب شنطة أو حاجة ممكن تكون فيها حاجات ممكن تعمل مشاكل. برضو نفس AvidGuard بيقدر ان هو يدتكت حاجات في ال يعني detect the behavior of employees inside an industrial facility, so whether they are wearing the right attire ولا لا. بيقدر برضو AvidGuard يعمل traffic يعني يقدر يعمل حاجات ليها علاقة بالintelligent traffic system زي traffic violations, زي moving in the wrong direction, زي parking in the wrong area and so on. وبرضه حاجات ليها علاقة بالhealth regulations اللي هي حاجات ليها علاقة بCOVID زي detected masks and so on. AvidHook is more about forensics. It's a video analytics tool, but it's more for it's offline tools. It takes video recordings. I can extract, يعني مثلا يبقى عندي video recordings قد كده وعايز اعرف في incident حصلت الاسبوع اللي فات يوم الثلاث من الساعة 12 للساعة 2 فاقدر اعرف اروح كتلي اقدر اعرف ايه اللي حصل واقدر ان انا احدد وارجع لمكان الـ surveillance recording اللي كان عمل حاجة زي كده. فده بالنسبة لأفيد هوك. أفيد ريتيل زي ما كنت شرحت قبل كده it's more about getting business intelligence about ريتيل. و finally AvidO2 is more about getting information about vehicles. تمام. ف these are the products. هنا كل الحاجات دي كلها based على it's deep learning model وبيتحول ل plugin into the platform and it extracts the information from the video surveillance cameras. All of the applications are real time except AvidHook, which is an offline tool. طيب ده كلام جميل ويعني اكيد الحاجات دي يعني you will learn at school computer vision and so on. في حاجة مهمة جدا يعني very important في الحاجات اللي احنا بنعملها اللي هي ال KPI, ال Key Performance Indicator. ازاي ان انا اعرف ال what I'm doing is يعني is good ولا is great or it's cutting edge or it's competitive مع ال products بره. ففي triangle كده اللي هو بيوري لك ازاي ان ممكن يعني when you build a product what are the things that you should be focused on so that يعني become competitive. Triangle ده يعني most likely you're able to achieve one or two but not all three at the same time لان هي it's a compromise يبقى دايما في trade off. فبالنسبه للكوست, الكوست بيترجم هنا في الفيديو اناليتكس performance. Video analytics بيستهلك a lot of hardware. When you go to the customer and you tell them, I have these features for you, they get excited and they get impressed and so on. And they say, yes, I would like to have this tomorrow. And then you tell them, no, but you have to buy this huge server, you have to have these GPUs and so on. They start to get lukewarm about the whole thing because they don't want the cost to be high. It's very important for any video analytics vendor to be, or in general, like any vendor of yani technology to be yani paying attention to the performance. Performance meaning you want to be able to optimize the amount of hardware in order to reduce the cost. For total cost of ownership, دي حاجة مهمة جدا. تاني حاجة, accuracy. فطبعا كل ما بتعلي الهاردوير which is يعني increase the cost accuracy بتتحسن لكن you want to have يعني very good accuracy and at the same time you want to keep the cost down and then when you go to the customer there's always a feature that you don't have it's a rule يعني every time you go to a customer he will always ask you about the feature that you do not have يعني حتى لو انت يعني you're يعني extremely careful and you developed everything in the world يعني that you think that people would need هيبقى دايما في حاجه عنده انت مش عندك ف features برضو features when you develop features you need to keep the accuracy of these features and you also need to make sure that the performance of these features is on par with the industrial standard so that it'll cost my drop shipping. What we do is we try to optimize the hardware. وفي يعني so many بقى techniques حاجة زي كده مش عايز يعني أخش معاكم في القصص دي بس يعني هو basically when you develop حاجة زي كده you develop using CPUs and GPUs. And sometimes you optimize for the GPUs and sometimes you optimize for the CPUs. And there are so many tools. NVIDIA طبعا is one of the يعني leading companies in GPUs and they have their tools and they have ways by which they can optimize. Intel on the other side is the primary يعني leader in CPU development and they have also tools for developing and both of them are always in a race to optimize their hardware so that it will be most suitable for video processing. تاني حاجة الانتجريشن integration with VMS vendors, IoT vendors, دي حاجة مهمة جدا and we're always يعني pushing to do. وبعدين تالت حاجة having video analytics that are يعني use cases that are important for the for the customer. So we have a full portfolio of the use cases or the most use cases that we know about. زي ما قلت قبل كده يعني دايما الكاستمر بيبقى عنده حاجه زياده that they would need to يعني add للموضوع. وبعدين اخر حاجه modular pricing. Everybody wants the price to be low and they don't want to pay for things that they don't want. فدي برضه حاجه that we look at. For the sake of time, هخلي الفيديو للاخر لو عندنا وقت. Let me go and from your perspective, what does this mean? فأنا هحاول يعني أحاول أترجم الحاجات دي ل what are the actions أو يعني the action items from your side that you need to pay attention to يعني along يعني the years of your studies إن شاء الله. فلو نتكلم على جاك, who's Jack? جاك اللي هو جاك ويلش. جاك ويلش ده كان الـ CEO بتاع جنرال إلكتريك, وكان he was well known for يعني he has an eye on picking people. فكان دايما الـ يعني الشعار بتاعه look for people with energy. مهمة جدا الـ energy في أي حاجة بتعملها, لازم عندك energy ولازم تبقى يعني full of energy كده. ثاني حاجة الـ ability to energize people around you. It's very important that you can not only have your own energy but يعني get people also to be يعني infected by your energy and also يعني you can spread the energy around so that there's good positive energy in the room. ثالث حاجة execution. في ناس كتيرة بتقدر إن هي تعمل الـ proof of concept, لكن to execute, to have the full product اللي هي الاتنشن تو ديتيل, دي مهمه جدا. having attention to detail ده بيخلي الاكسكيوشن سموث وبيخلي الان جول يعني always يعني rewarding. فدي دي حاجه مهمه. واخر حاجه طبعا ودي اهم حاجه فيهم passion. يعني ما حدش هيشتغل حاجه ما بيحبهاش. ف it's always يعني you have to have passion and يعني يعني you have to like what you're doing. دي حاجه في منتهى الأهمية. طيب هنشوف حد تاني برضو قال إيه. كولين باول ده برضو يعني one of the great leaders في الـ US, في الـ US Army. ف one of his rules بقى for picking people بيقول إيه, look for intelligence, judgment and capacity to anticipate and see around corners. Loyalty, integrity, high energy drive, balanced ego and drive to get things done. ففي حاجات كثيرة يعني يعني you can learn, there's a lot of skills that you can learn, but يعني مهم جدا that you practice judgment. يعني يعني يبقى قدامك يعني دايما strategy. What strategy is about? Strategy is about picking a path and saying no to another path. ما ينفعش الواحد يعمل كل حاجة. فمهم جدا ان الواحد يبقى عنده يعني good judgment و good decision making right from the beginning. Integrity طبعا يعني المفروض طبعا اكيد كلنا عندنا integrity. دي حاجه يعني حاجه مفروض بتبقى في التربيه وفي الاديان. بس في حاجه مهمه جدا برضه في القصه دي, في قصه الانتجريتي, ان taking short cuts sometimes يعني does not yield the optimal outcome. فدي حاجه مهمه جدا ان الواحد دايما وهو بيعمل حاجه يعني يبقى making sure ان هي يعني it's the right thing for the right outcome. يعني ممكن تعمل proof of concept تقول انا في حاجات معينه انا ما عملتهاش بس هي كده دي الحاجه في الاخر هتبقى شكلها كده, بس ما اجيش اعمل نفس الحاجه بقى في البرودكت. يعني المفروض في البرودكت ما اخدش بقى شورت كات في البرودكت ابقى عارف بالظبط ايه اللي حصل, لان الشورت كات دي will bite you in the future for sure. No, يعني ما فيش اي تفكير ان هي will not come and bite you in the future. طيب الحاجة التانية قصة الإيجو. طبعا الإيجو ده بيبوظ حاجات كتير, ودايما هتلاقي يعني scientists will have very low ego. يعني هتلاقيهم دايما they're humble, ودايما يعني people who have يعني very high ego يعني هتلاقيهم they're hiding يعني ignorance behind arrogance. ف try always to have a balanced ego في الموضوع. واهم حاجه الدرايف, درايف تو جيت ثينجز دون. دي من الحاجات من الصفات, وكل الحاجات دي يا جماعه دي مش حاجه بنتعلمها في الجامعه ولا كده, دي حاجة المفروض نبراكتس في أي حاجة بنعملها سواء في الجامعة أو خارج الجامعة. فاي هوب يعني تبقى حاجة that you practice all the time إن شاء الله. طيب بالنسبة لل AI in general candidate, what are يعني أو أنا بتكلم على مثلاً AvidBeam أو كده, إيه الحاجات اللي إحنا we're looking for technical things. We're looking for a deep understanding of deep learning technology, research and application computer vision. ده بيبقى سيكتور, مش يعني أنا بتكلمش على الواحد لازم يبقى عارف كل الحاجات دي, يبقى عارف أي حاجة من الحاجات دي. ده division. الحاجة الثانية knowledge and experience of programming and API design. وزي ما قلت API اللي هي application interface using C و C++ و Java, Python, script languages. Language ما تهمش, لكن المهم يبقى عندك يعني structured mind and being a software engineer, not a programmer. So there's an important difference. الحاجة الكاتيجوري الثالثة هي big data. في tools كتيرة ال big data بقى أكيد يعني مؤجد exposure to زي Spark وزي Hadoop وزي Zero MQ, حاجات كتيرة جدا. Kubernetes is on the rise. So Kubernetes is one of the tools that are يعني extremely demanded. So يعني I would encourage you to look at it and يعني to practice. وهنا بقول إيه يعني يعني don't just learn the thing. يعني try to do a project with it so that you can have a deliverable في الآخر. وبعدين في DevOps knowing the cycle مهم جدا تبقى يعني to practice the cycle دي حتى في البروجكت الصغيرة اللي تعملها in the form of sprint, تعملها تبقوا يعني حتى even تبقوا عاملين mock-up كده ازاي ان انا هاخد ال product او ال prototype اللي بعمله ده to the quality, يبقى في نوع من ال quality assurance برضو فيه, بحيث ان احنا ان انت في الاخير تبقى ايه تقول انا بوصل ده from scratch to a product. فدي مهمة. الكاتيجوري الخامسة اللي هي الباك اند او الفرونت اند تكنولوجيز اند يوزر اكسبيرينس. دي برضو دي من الحاجات اللي احنا محتاجينها جدا والحاجات اللي احنا بنفوكس عليها. طيب ان اديشن تو الحاجات دي طبعا مهم جدا ان الشخص يبقى عنده يعني جود ليرنينج سكيلز, يبقى فاست ليرنر, وبيقدر ان هو يستخدم الايديز دي into new solutions and products. فدي that's a given. You will always be in continuous learning. تقول بقى انا خلاص اتعلمت حاجات في الجامعه ويعني مش محتاج اتعلم حاجات تاني. هيبقى دايما في حاجات جديده. تاني حاجه يعني creativity, ودي حاجه ما بتبقاش موجوده لناس كثيره بس هي بتيجي بالبراكتس. يعني believe me, يعني مش يعني قصه ان انا عندي موهبه الكريتيفيتي دي انا I don't believe in. انا I believe ان you can always تطوع نفسك ان انت تبقى creative. You can always think outside the box and يعني lead yourself into solving hard problems. طيب في حاجة تانية مهمة جدا بقى قصة ال corporate culture دي. Corporate culture يعني بيبقى احيانا ال corporate life بتفرض عليك culture معين you have to be يعني adopting. وال culture برضو هيرجع لل soft skills اللي احنا كنا نتكلم عنها قبل كده, منها مثلا الديسيبلين. يعني you have to be شخص ديسيبلين من ناحيه لما بتوعد مثلا بسكيدجول معين بتنفذ السكيدجول ده. لما بتوعد ان انت هتدليفر حاجه في وقت معين you make sure that you reach it. الحاجه الثانيه ريسك تيكينج, تقدر انت تاخد يعني انفورمد ريسك, مش اي ريسك, مش ريسك ممكن تضيع الدنيا. في ريسك طبعا بتضيع الدنيا, ف I want to make sure and انت يعني you enhance change and challenge the status quo and also يعني take informed risks. حاجة very very important results orientation. دي يعني الactivities ملهاش أي قيمة. يعني إن أنا حضرت meeting, إن أنا عملت research على 500 paper. It doesn't يعني ما فيش أي أنا رحت قريت 40 paper في الويكند. ما فيش اي حاجه. الفكره ايه ان what is the deliverable في الاخر, what can I يعني what did I learn, what's the outcome of this يعني activity experience. ميتنج يبقى انا في الميتنج ده خدت اكشن ايتمز كذا وكذا وكذا ونفذت كذا، عملت ديليفري لدوكيمنت فلانيه، عملت ديليفري لكود بشكل معين، عملت ديليفري لبرودكت بشكل معين وهكذا. الريزلت اورينتيشن دي حاجه يعني في منتهى الاهميه. كاستمر اورينتيشن كل الناس اللي حواليك اللي بتشتغل معاك those are customers for you. So you need to listen and respond to your customers appropriately. You need to clearly communicate. مهم جدا communication سواء verbal ولا مكتوبة. دي حاجة في منتهى الأهمية. وبعدين في الكواليتي طبعا. You need to have produced things with quality. You need to مهم جدا إن يبقى شغلك مع الناس you're having fun وانت بتعمله في نفس الوقت. يعني you're able انت تشتغل مع الناس in a teamwork وبشكل open and direct. مهم جدا ان التيم كله يبقى متجانس، لان احيانا وللاسف دي بتحصل في شركات كتير، احيانا الانفايرمنت نفسه بيبقى بيبقى فيه نيجاتيف انرجي كده بتسبب الناس ما تبقاش موتيفيتد. فمهم جدا قصه جيت بليس تو ورك دي بتخلي الموتيفيشن عاليه وبتخلي الناس اكسايتد and wanting to do their يعني work with their full capacity. طيب الاكشن بتاعتك ايه بقى؟ الاكشن بتاعتنا كلنا ان احنا نسترنثن الاندستريال سكيلز. فناخد بالنا في البروجكتس اللي احنا بنعملها نعمل حاجات اللي هي يعني could be useful for my resume. ما تبقاش بتعمل انا عايز اخلص من الكورس ده وخلاص وعايز اعمل اي حاجه بسرعه كده بحيث ان انا اقدر اذكر واجيب اعلى مارك. على فكره ما حدش بيبص على المارك بتاعتك، يعني طبعا ده في your GPA is very important both academically and industry، بس ما حدش بيروح يشوف انت جبت كام في كمبيوتر فيجن كورس او في الاي اي كورس اللي انا اخذته، بس بيبص على البروجكت بتاعتك اللي انت عملتها، انت عملت ايه وانت دي تبقى ريفلكتد في الريزومي and what have you done في البروجكت ده وتعلمت ايه. فدي مهمه جدا ان you have to be aware of. الحاجه الثانيه التكنولوجي ايكو سيستم عمال بيتغير كل شويه. النهارده زمان كان برولوج كان شغال، بعد كده كان في ليسب، وبعدين النهارده في بايثون. You have to be fully aware of this technology ecosystem وبتتحرك معاه دايما، يعني بنيوز جروبس بقى بتبقى متابع على طول على الحاجات، تخش على كاجل، تخش على الحاجات اللي هي تخليك دايما always يعني learning new things and learning the technology ecosystem and practice thinking out of the box. في طرق كتيرة نقدر نعملها في القصص دي. Exposure to design and product cycle، يعني make sure in one of your courses you execute a project with the full product cycle from gathering the requirements all the way to delivering يعني a good prototype. دي مهمة جدا برضو في ال experience بتاعتك as you prepare yourself for the industry. تالت حاجة immerse yourself in the corporate culture. يبقى show يعني how يعني you're able to meet ال corporate culture values اللي هي موجودة، سواء من ناحية الكواليتي، سواء من ناحية results orientation، سواء يعني دي حاجة you can practice from day one. ف it's very important that you can practice this. وكل الحاجات دي يعني applicable على الجامعة زي ما هي applicable على الاندستري. وبليني يعني في الآخر يعني آخر السنة حتى في evaluation طبعا في ال in the corporate world، ففي آخر السنة بيبقى ال evaluation بتاعتك على ال technical skills، your competency، your own competency، انت بتعرف ايه، انت فت الشركه بايه. تاني حاجه ال your adaptation to the corporate culture، يعني انت عملت ايه في الكوربريت كلتشر اللي الناس شايفه ان انت your compliant with. وبعدين تالت حاجه your impact، ودي اهم حاجه، ازاي الحاجه بتاعتك، هل الحاجه بتاعتك affected الشخص اللي جنبيك ولا affected البرودكت ككل ولا affected الشركه ككل ولا affected الاندستري ككل. فدي برضو حاجه يعني that you can start thinking about from دلوقتي. Finally في الاخر لان احنا we're running out of time، from يعني a computer vision perspective انا شايف ان احنا we're still at an early adoption phase. الدنيا لسه في حاجات كتيرة جدا ممكن تحصل في قصة الكمبيوتر فيجن دي لسه ما حصلتش. وحتى even في الـ يعني في الـ not only in the يعني detection of objects كده, لكن detection of events and learning from events and having this perpetual learning machine, دي في حاجات كتيرة جدا المفروض تحصل. Scalability ممكن تيجي مع البيج داتا تول وcombining البيج داتا مع الديب ليرنينج can pave the way for solving a lot of mysteries and uncertainties في القصة دي. لو دكتور محمد احنا عندنا وقت for a very short video.
لا اعتقد لا, لان في another talk at one, so I think it's better to take questions. لو في questions
okay sure please.
اي اسئلة؟ اي سؤال؟ افتح ليه؟ افتح الفيديو بس الفيديو شغال المفروض. يا اوكي. اي كويستشنز؟ طيب هو ما فيش نو كويستشنز. انا كنت عايز اشكر دكتور هاني واشكركم على الحضور.
اوكي
واحنا المفروض ان اكشلي الكلام دكتور هاني السكيلز نيدد في الجراديويتس وال whether personal skills زي احنا عندنا projects every term من اول خالص whether في عندنا projects جوه كمان السبجكتس يعني whether في الاي تي سكول ولا في engineering school وهوبفلي كل التولز اكشلي تستخدم ستادي بايثون وسي وسي بلس بلس وكل اللي يعني حاجات كثيره من دكتور هاني اتكلم عليها. فان شاء الله يعني
Thank you very much. Hey, thank you so much. Thank you for this opportunity. وإن شاء الله بإذن الله يعني أشوفكم applying to AvidBeam soon إن شاء الله بإذن الله.
Thank you.
شكرا.
Thank you. مش عارف الكاميرا مش مطلعاني. طلع لي. طيب اوكي. Thank you. Bye bye.
سلام. سلام شكرا.
سويتش ازاي؟
كنت عايز اسلم عليه.